much for America as a leader of the free world. We are out of the Paris Climate Accord.
Media reaction is that it's an extraordinary abdication of American leadership. It is a shameful moment for the United States.
Right now, they're weeping. They're sad that the United States is withdrawing from its leadership role because, you know, frankly, they know that it means a less stable world.
Well, the great madness over the Paris Agreement consumes all in its path. Thousands of celebrities and talking heads and other wise men are crying out all at once, proclaiming the supreme importance of an agreement that they, for the most part, know virtually nothing about. Mark Green is a former New York City public advocate. He's also the founder of Shadowing Trump. It's an anti-Trump shadow cabinet. That cabinet has been particularly unhappy about the Paris pullout, tweeting, quote, "This is not a democracy. Trump's like a lethal spreading virus. Either he kills us or we stop him." Mark Green joins us tonight. Now, Mark, I know you don't like Trump, and you've got
That's a pretty good metaphor.
Well, it's a grotesque metaphor, but let's get specific rather than metaphorical, if we could,
sure.
Just for one second, because you're a smart guy. So a lot of things you disagree with Trump, fine. But the Paris Agreement is what people are upset about right now. And I'm just wondering why, if you really cared about CO2 emissions, you would back an agreement that doesn't hold China or India, two of the biggest polluters in the world, to reducing those emissions, as the Paris Agreement doesn't. Why would you be in favor of that?
The UN realized after the Kyoto Agreement that they couldn't have binding standards. And so they decided, with John Kerry among them, to have voluntary standards. So how do you make sure that China lives up to its voluntary standards? Or Germany, or America, or Russia? Well, peer pressure around the world, because we live in one lifeboat, there's no planet B. So they came up with an idea that, Tucker, it's not about hypocrisy. Ann Coulter is right. We're all sinners. On the one side is Donald Trump, who, talk about not knowing what's in the agreement, is obviously a guy who's quite ill-equipped, inexperienced, and without knowledge about issues like this. He was very good on real
estate.
Really?
Because you've already made a mistake in characterizing the agreement, so I wonder how much you know.
Well,
so all the agreement is voluntary.
It's voluntary.
The whole thing is.
Trump's statement at the Rose Garden said, this non-binding agreement is so draconian. Which is it? Is it coercive and draconian? On the other side, a majority of voters in every state, according to Frank Luntz, wants to stay in Paris.
Okay,
But
you're not answering my question. I asked you a specific. Okay, everyone wants it. Great. But because you're a smart guy, I want you to talk about the agreement itself, not the politics of the agreement.
Okay.
And I want you to tell me why, if you're concerned about CO2, you think that's causing global warming, why you would back an agreement that does not require two of the biggest polluters in the world, even voluntarily, to reduce their CO2 emissions till 2030 and allows China to continue using coal and ramping up its coal use for the next 5 years. Why is that good?
You can't make the perfect the enemy of the good. Something that we would agree with in the abstract. The UN and the world can't have an entity that would challenge our sovereignty or China's sovereignty. So they came up with something, Tucker, that 194 nations, from Kim Jong-un to Putin to George W. Bush, said is the best way to continue the acceleration of less carbon. And so, you know, the market has been working.
But that's not what it says.
It says it's non-binding, no, and every country sets its own standards
Why should we support something that doesn't even set voluntary limits on CO2 emissions for China and India and call that environmentalism? It's the opposite of environmentalism.
No, it's not. Well, then why do all environmentalists, scientists...
I'm asking you. I'm not asking about other people who aren't present. I want to know your view of it.
I will. My view is identical to 98% of scientists, all world leaders, and the majority of voters. Staying in Paris would help reduce carbon over time because China, India, and America, all three have been the biggest carbon emitters in the last few decades, have said, okay, well, we're not going to shut down our coal plants now. None of that's required, as you know. Coal is down in America.
They're going to increase coal usage in China. And increase it.
The peak coal in China, the chart shows it's here. And now, by
no,
the way,
that's
China,
not true. That is not what it says.
China
it says
knows
that China,
its cities. China's choking on its cities.
Of course, we agree
on
that. My point is, you guys are selling this agreement. You're lying about what it says. It doesn't actually promise or even hold them to a non-binding pledge that they will reduce their CO2 emissions anytime in the near future. Why don't you just say that out loud? Because that's true. And yet it does require the United States to do that. Why?
Hold it. It requires the United States to do it. You know that's wrong. Please.
Requires the United States to pledge that we will do it in a non-binding
way.
That
we'll try.
And by the same criteria that apply to India and China. But if CO2 itself is a poison, as you believe it is, then why the hell would we get behind something that allows the biggest CO2 emitter in the world to increase its CO2 emissions?
Would you like to see less CO2 in the atmosphere?
You're dodging my question. I'm saying, why wouldn't you have an agreement that says we pledge to reduce it now, not a generation from now?
We do pledge to start reducing it.
No, they don't.
One second. They have said voluntarily that we are aiming to reduce carbon over time. So unlike you, I agree with the world scientists, businessmen, and countries. But you can laugh.
So stupid. Scientists and businessmen. I'm asking you specific questions. You're not giving me specific answers, and you're appealing to people who aren't here whose names you don't know. So, like, that's not an answer.
Hold it. The answer is, with Paris, countries have a moral suasion to keep progress on keeping. Do you know who Lysenko was?
Of course I do. Okay. He was the Soviet scientist who, like you, substituted religion for science and wound up with insane conclusions.
He said you could learn traits could be inherited. Yeah. Why do all scientists oppose you, Tucker Carlson?
I don't oppose me. I'm asking questions because it's not a religion, it's science.
And
you don't answer
Elon
them.
Musk
you throw
private
religion back at me. Mark, it's great to see you.
Facts are facts.
Keep the